guys. This is Sports with Dylan. Today I'll be doing a review of the Olympics. So I'm just going to quickly go over the medals here. USA came in first with 39 gold, 41 silver, and 33 bronze for a total of 113. China came in second with 38 gold, 32 silver, and 18 bronze for a total of 88. Japan came in third with 27 gold, 14 silver, and 17 bronze for a total of 58. Great Britain came in fourth with a total of 22 gold, 21 silver, and 22 bronze for a total of 65. The Russian Olympic Committee, which is just Russia, except Russia was banned for encouraging the usage of performance enhancement drugs. So it's just the athletes performing under a different name. Anyways, the Russian Olympic Committee came in fifth with 20 gold, 28 silver, and 23 bronze for a total of 71. Australia came in sixth with a total of 17 gold, 7 silver, and 22 bronze for a total of 46. The Netherlands came in seventh with a total of 10 gold, 12 silver, and 14 bronze for a total of 36. France came in eighth with a total of 10 gold, 12 silver, and 11 bronze for a total of 33. Germany came in ninth with 10 gold, 11 silver, and 16 bronze for a total of 37. Italy came in 10th with a total of 10 gold, 10 silver, and 20 bronze for a total of 40. And last on this list, but definitely not least, Canada came in 11th with 7 gold, 6 silver, and 11 bronze for a total of 24. So let's start with tennis, shall we? Daniil Medvedev, who is Russian, beat Riley Opeka in the men's singles match for gold. Karolina Pliskova, who is Czech, beat Camille Giorgi in the women's singles match for gold. Nikola Mektik and Mate Pavic lost to Rajiv Ram and Joe Salisbury, who are American and British respectively, in the men's doubles match. And Gabriela Dabrowski, who is Canadian, and Luisa Stefani, who is Brazilian, beat Andrea Klepok and Darja Jurak in the women's doubles match for gold. Now, in baseball, Japan beat the U.S. in the gold medal match. So this is quite big because baseball is actually more popular in Japan than it is in the U.S. But think of all those MLB players. Most of them are American. So for Japan to beat U.S. is huge. And Japan is quite happy about it because they beat U.S. at their own sport. Now, in basketball, then U.S. won both. Ironically, in the women's match, they did beat Japan. Men's, it was France, but no surprises there. Basketball is really only big in USA. Kind of surprised they have that at the Olympics. Like, they don't have football at the Olympics for that reason. There's almost only American players. Now, in golf, which is pretty much the only sport I watched, then Xander Schauffele came in first at minus 18. He won gold. Followed by Rory Sabatini, who came in second with minus 17. Then there's this huge tie at minus 15 with CT Pan, Colin Morikawa, Mito Pereira, Sebastian Munoz, Rory McIlroy, Paul Casey, and Hideki Matsuyama. So they had this huge playoff, and CT Pawn, never heard of the guy, end up coming in first for that playoff, so he ended up winning bronze. So, for soccer, Brazil beat Spain in men's soccer for the gold. But most importantly, Canada beat Sweden for women's soccer. Now that's not actually the most important part. Because you see, Canada beat US, which is the rival that's beaten them so many times. So for them to beat US is just so fun to see. And even better, we end up being Sweden as well and winning gold. But still, we beat US. Now this interview is kind of annoying. I'll let you watch it with US's star player, Megan Rapinoe.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, not our best game, not our best tournament. We didn't have it today. I think just, you know, too many errors from us again. I felt like the space was there for us to play in, and we just couldn't get into it. Too many touches or, you know, an errant touch, and that's football. I got, I think, one shot on goal and a PK. And from what it sounds like, it was a PK. So, yeah, it's a bitter one to swallow. Obviously, we never want to lose to Canada. I don't think I've ever lost to Canada. So it's a bitter one. And obviously, you know, still a lot to compete for. That's what I told the girls. And, you know, we talked about in the huddle. It's not the color we want, but there's still medal on the line. So that's a huge thing. And we want to win that game. But, yeah, this is, this sucks.
Now, this drives me crazy because it's the typical American reaction. It's not that the Canadians were actually better. It's that they weren't playing well. She even went and said, no one wants to lose to Canada. I mean, seriously, that's mean. We were the better team. Maybe you guys weren't playing your best, but we are a better team right now. For surfing, Carissa Moore, who's American, won gold for women's, and Italo Ferreira, who's Brazilian, won gold for men's. So, as most of you will know, there are quite a few different events in track and field, so I'm just going to do the most important ones. Let's start with men's, shall we? In high jump, Mustaz Essebarshim, sorry if I completely butchered this name. You're going to find that I'm going to butcher a lot of these names. And Gianmarco Tamberi tied for first place, who are from Qatar and Italy, respectively. In the 100-meter sprint, Lamont Jacobs came in first, Fred Curley came in second, and Andre DeGrasse came in third. Lamont Jacobs is Italian, Fred Curley is American, and Andre DeGrasse is obviously Canadian. In long jump, Militadis Tentoglou, see what I mean? He's Greek. He came in first. For the 400-meter hurdles, Karsten Warholm broke a world record and came in first. For the 200-meter sprint, Andre DeGrasse came in first. We got our first gold medal. Kenneth Bednarik, who's American, came in second, and Noah Lyles, who's also American, came in third. In the 110-meter hurdles, Hansel Parchment, who's Jamaican, came in first. In the 20-kilometer race walk, which is a short marathon, Massimo Stanno came in first. In the 50-kilometer race walk, which is longer than the average marathon, Dawid Tomala came in first. In the 5,000-meter sprints, Joshua Cheptegei, who's Ugandan, came in first. Mohamed Ahmed, who's Canadian, came in second. And Paul Chelimo, who's American, came in third. In the 4x100 relay, so it's four sprinters, each doing 100 meters, Italy came in first. Great Britain came in second. And Canada came in third. I'm going to talk about that in a second. In the 4x400 relay, which is four people running 400 meters each, US came in first. The Netherlands came in second. And Botswana came in third. And in the decathlon, Damien Warner, who's Canadian, got gold. Now, for the women's events, in the 100-meter sprint, Elaine Thompson-Hara, who's Jamaican, got gold. Shelly Ann Fraser-Price, who's also Jamaican, got silver. And Sharika Jackson, who is also Jamaican, got bronze. That's just a great run for Jamaica. In the 100-meter hurdles, Jasmine Camacho-Quinn, who's from Puerto Rico, and for some reason, then the Olympics recognizes Puerto Rico as an independent country from the U.S. Anyways, she got first. In the 5,000-meter sprints, Sifan Hansen, who's Dutch, came in first. In long jump, Malaika Mihambo, who's German, came in first. The 200-meter sprints, Elaine Thompson-Hara, who also won the 100-meter sprints, came in first. Christine Mwamba, who's Namibian, came in second. And Gabrielle Thomas, who's American, came in third. In the 400-meter hurdles, Sydney McLaughlin, who's American, broke the world record. In the 20-kilometer race walk, which I talked about before, Antonella Palmaniso, who's Italian, came in first. Sandra Lorena Arenas, who's Colombian, came in second. And Hong Lui, who's Chinese, came in third. In the 4x100 relay, which, as I said, four sprinters, 100 meters each, Jamaica came in first, US came in second, and Great Britain came in third. In the marathon, which is shorter than the 50-kilometer race walk, it's like 45 kilometers, maybe a bit less, I don't know. Anyways, Peres Jepchirchir, who's Kenyan, came in first. Brigitte Kosgei, who's Kenyan, came in second. And Molly Sidel, who's American, came in third. In high jump, Maria Lasdiskin, who's the first medal from the Russian Olympic Committee, came in first. And the 4x400 relay, four sprinters, 400 meters each, US came in first, Poland came in second, and Jamaica came in third. Now, remember how I said that Canada came in third for the 4x100 relay? Well, on the British team, Shijindu Uja tested positive for performance enhancement drugs, which means that that team's medal might be taken away. So Canada might move up to silver. Canada currently has 2 gold, 1 silver, and 3 bronze. Now, Sadiq Miku, Benik Abramyan, and Mark Otieno Odhamio also tested positive for performance enhancement drugs. And they're still getting the results in on most of these people, so a lot of these could change. So, in gymnastics, as you all will know, Simone Biles dropped out of every event except for women's balance beam, where she only got bronze. In the men's artistic team all around, the ROC came out on top. Same for women's artistic team all around. In the men's artistic all-around, which is the same thing, but without a team, Daki Hashimoto, who's Japanese, won. And in women's, it was Sunisa Lee, who's American. In men's vault, Shin Ji-hwan, who's from South Korea, won. And in women's vault, Rebecca Andrade, who's Brazilian, won. In men's pommel horse, Max Whitlock, who's British, won. And in women's uneven bars, Nina Derwel, who's from Belgium, won. In men's rings, Lui Yang, who's from China, won. In women's balance beam, Guan Shenshen won from China. And in men's parallel bars, Zhu Jinghuan, who's also from China, won. And in men's horizontal bar, Daki Hashimoto won again. Now, it just got really dark in here, so I'm gonna go turn on some lights.
A few moments later.
That's better. Now, for diving, China absolutely dominated. You'll see what I mean. So, for the men's 3-meter springboard, ZC won gold. For the women's 3-meter springboard, Shi Tiangmo also won gold. For the men's 10-meter platform, Kale Yuan won gold. And for the women's 10-meter platform, Quan Hongshan won gold. All of them are from China. Now, for swimming, in the men's 400-meter medley, which is basically a series of different types of swims, then Chase Caliz, who's from America, won. In the women's 400 medley, Yui Ohashi, who's Japanese, won. In the women's 4x100-meter medley, which, as you would know by now, 4 people, 100 meters each, US won. They also won for men's. In the men's 100-meter freestyle, so that's front crawl, Caleb Dressel won. He's from America. In the women's 100-meter freestyle, Emma McKinnon won. She's from Australia. In the men's 200-meter freestyle, Tom Dean from Great Britain won. And in the women's 200-meter freestyle, Ariana Titimus, who's Australian, won. The men's 800-meter freestyle, Robert Fink, who's American, won. And the women's 800-meter freestyle, Kathleen Ledecky, who's American, won. In the women's 4x100-meter freestyle, Australia won. The men's 4x100-meter freestyle, US won. For weightlifting, the men's 109-kilogram, Akbar Jurev, who's from Uzbekistan, came on top. In men's 96 kilogram, Ibrahim Fars Elkbach, who's from Qatar, came up on top. In the women's 87 kilogram, Zuyu Wang, who's from China, won. In the men's 81 kilogram, Zhao Liu, who's also from China, won. In the women's 76 kilogram, Patricia Niesi Berra de Jong from Ecuador won. And in the women's 64 kilogram, Maud Charron, who's from Canada, won. And lastly today, in biking, in the men's road race, Richard Carapaz, who's from Ecuador, won. And in the women's road race, Anna Kaisenhofer, who's Austrian, won gold. In the women's team sprint, China won. And in the men's team sprint, the Netherlands won. Thanks for watching.